Welcome to Lifetime Adventures. Today I'm on the road and I'm up in Massachusetts and I'm going to a motorcycle meet. It's called Rice-O-Rama and it's displaying all foreign motorcycles made in Asia. And there's going to be a swap meet and a lot of interesting motorcycles to see. So come on along and let's go to Rice-O-Rama. It's a nice, clear, sunny day here out on the back roads of Massachusetts. We're heading up to Spencer, Massachusetts at the Spencer Fairgrounds. I'm gonna check out some Japanese and mostly Japanese, I believe, motorcycles. There might be some other different motorcycles there from Asia, but this particular motorcycle show is geared towards Asian motorcycles. So it should be interesting. Right now I don't own an Asian motorcycle, but I've been looking at some Kawasaki's, Yamaha's. They produce some really, really quality machine. I've owned them, and Hondas, I've owned them in the past. Should be interesting. Bring back some memories. I'll look at some of the old bikes I've ridden in the past. I'm sure that'll be at this show. Boy, here it is. Bikes and people around here. Find a place to park this machine. Well, there's my URAL. I'm supposed to meet up with my son and his son. I don't know if I can park next to it or not. Well, it sure is fun walking around and seeing some old machines and some fairly new ones too. And lots of parts here to look over if you ever need any parts off of foreign Asian motorcycles. Boy, they've got them here. Everything you could possibly find.
And one was black.
Hey, there he is. He made it over here.
looking for.
I had one of these in the past.
Because not all dealers, but you can't know some didn't even exist. And then, some guy comes in the showroom, he's looking at the black bomber, and the salesman said, no, we have a pipe we can put on it, you know?
Oh, yeah.
And so he buys it, they put the pipe on it, now they bring it. So there was a lot of that. And then shortly after,
you know, I'm kind of curious
about the recall all the kits. So there's no.
This guy gets around. He's been to almost all the motorcycle meets. 754 Honda. High rising pipes. That's my 754. Made into a cafe style. Nice job. Yamaha's version of a on-off motorcycle back in the day. 200cc twin with high pipes. That's a rare machine. RC30 Honda.
Right here, buddy.
Well, I enjoyed walking around here today. Now I'm going to go take a look at another motorcycle meet, and we'll see what we can find there. So stay tuned. The fun's not over. Well, my son and grandson are getting on the R1200 GS, and I'll be taking the URAL RETRO to Sturbridge, Massachusetts, to the IMOC rally, Italian Motorcycle Owners Club. And we're going to check out some Italian motorcycles there. Have some fun. Yep. I'll be taking the Euro, and we'll have some fun looking at some all Italian motorcycles. So come along and keep the fun rolling. Well, we're heading out to the next show. We're entering Brookfield, Massachusetts, and we'll be going by Quaybog Pond over here, and it's a fairly large pond, and brings back memories because in the past, when I was flying my lake amphibian aircraft, which was capable of landing on the water, I used to land at this little pond. And actually, when I was learning how to fly amphibious airplanes, I took lessons and landed in this pond for the first time on water. It was a fun time. Very nice body of water fed by the Quaybog River here. This is another location that has some memories for me. Years ago, I had a wedding reception here, and boy, we had a wonderful time. It is a very nice facility up here with a gun range and ponds to fish in. And today, we have an Italian motorcycle rally. Rod and Gun Club, the Italian motorcycle meet. How you doing, girls?
Very well.
Well, you can just go right in.
I can.
Yeah.
That's a microphone.
Is it real?
Yeah, I do a YouTube channel. What is this?
time at the Ducati and Moto Guzzi and the Caviga. A lot of different Italian-made motorcycles here to see. We're gonna take a look at them. Well, I got here a little late today, but there are some bikes, beautiful bikes here to see. Look at this machine. Three-cylinder LaVerta. Don't see one of them very often. Starting to head out today. And the Marini. That's kind of a rare bike. That's kind of a rare bike. Yeah.
Well, there are at least two of us here. So.
What year is that?
This is a 78.
78, wow.
I had it brand new.
You had it since then? Wow. That's cool.
I've had it for a few.
Yeah. Nice. I remember those. I never owned one though. I owned the Hondas back then. But,
ah.
Yeah. Have a happy ride. There's a machine I remember. A friend of mine had one of those. He used to ride it all the time. When it ran. They weren't the extremely reliable machines. This is what Ducati was racing back in the day. Like this one,
do you have to pull the mufflers off in order to get the axle out, or does it come out that way?
Actually, neither. It comes right straight out.
Yeah, but
once you loosen it up,
yeah,
it just pulls backwards.
Oh, so but another, if you loosen it, you get the chain off, then you can slide it out.
Right. Oh, I usually just take the chain off at the mast one.
But yeah, you could do that.
You could move it all the way up, but yeah, it's easier just to loosen everything up.
Was that the grand prize? Did you?
I don't know if they had a grand prize.
Oh.
One best of Cotty, so.
That one best of all. I can see why.
What was the idea of that?
That's the adjustment.
Well, there's a unique machine. Moto Guzzi.
Yeah.
An older one.
59.
Wow. Nice machine.
Thank you.
Yeah. Does it run well?
Yeah. Older, small bike. It runs well.
Yeah. Yeah, I got the Ducati Monster 1100 Evo, a 2010 model.
Yeah. A lot different than this.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 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 Single-cylinder Ducati. Nice location here for motorcycles.
Rizzo. Nice.
Yeah. Be yours if you want.
Boy, you don't see them like, you don't see the Grizzles around very often. Nice. Yeah. Beautiful bike. I've got one of those.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's an older one here, an 850. A lot of B85s. This is a unique one right here. Check this out. It's a V7 Special. Termagoni exhaust.
Yeah, can you take the foot peg?
Boy, the GTS was great. Spent a lot of time restoring that one.
Huh?
Spent a lot of time restoring that one.
A couple of times. Yeah. That's how you know how long you've had a motorcycle.
Yep.
How many times you've restored it.
Yep, yep. Beautiful though. I remember those.
That's probably Fighter 140 back. How far they had.
Got the 996.
How far they had.
Enjoyed seeing some of the motorcycles here today at this show and the previous show. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to leave a thumbs up, hit the notification bell for the new videos coming out soon, and be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.